Will enter the ring in this deserted arena and expose some of the greatest secrets of all. The secrets of pro wrestling.
I'll show you how fake it is.
These brave men are risking their careers, as well as their personal safety, to reveal what wrestling federations don't want you to know.
There will be some people that are angry at me for what I'm doing here.
They make it look so real, even though it isn't.
What do you mean by fake? Do you want me to tell you that we know who's going to win and lose? If you're overly concerned about whether you win or lose, you're in the wrong business. It's not real. Totally predetermined. Tell the truth. Look, it's fake.
But don't be mistaken. If you think wrestling is all just one big hoax, you may be shocked when you discover the secrets. Before we get to the action, let's meet the masked men who will expose wrestling's greatest secrets. The wrestlers' names and appearances have been changed to protect their true identities. Here is Brute Force. The All-American Boy. Colossus. Ben Hurt. Private Pain.
You stay in your corner until you get attacked.
Skullduggery. Slither. And Brash Knuckles.
There's no way getting around it. You watch TV every Monday night and you can see, oh, they're stomping when they punch. Oh, they're stomping when they kick. I mean, it doesn't take a genius to figure out that punches are pulled.
Every wrestling match is filled with explosive action. Violence looks real because the men in the ring employ secret tricks to make it look a lot more dangerous than it really is. The deception starts with five basic moves that every wrestler needs to know. Wrestling basic number one, the body slam.
Most people think when you're body slammed in the ring, it doesn't hurt. Nothing can be further from the truth.
That's because you're lifted 6 feet above the ring and slammed into the mat at full force. There's a secret to how it works. First, Private Pain isn't lifting Ben Hurt by himself. They're actually working together to pull off this trick. It's really Ben who's pushing off of Private Pain's thighs to launch himself into the air. See? There's the push-off. But that's not the only secret. Private Pain isn't trying to hurt his opponent. He's actually trying to help him by not slamming him down until his head is safely tucked in. He avoids injury by landing flat on his back and not on his head. Now for basic rule number two, the punch.
If a 280-pound guy punched a 300-pound guy in the face, he'd either have no teeth or a broken jaw.
He's right. No one could take a beating like this if the punches were real. So what's the secret?
Almost all the wrestlers in the ring tend to work light. We touch very light. All the holes are very light. Because we might make it look as believable as possible, with as little injury to each other as possible.
Just like in a back alley brawl, a closed fist can cause serious damage when it lands on someone's chin. So how do the wrestlers avoid getting hurt? Here's the secret. An open fist, which doesn't pack any real punch. Unlike movie stuntmen, wrestlers don't swing and miss. They make light contact so their opponent will know when to react. From this angle, we can see that the punches are so light, they barely touch the wrestler's stomach. But the fans think they're real because they don't know the secrets. On to basic move number three, the stomp. There's always a lot of stomping going on inside the ring. No, these wrestlers aren't doing the Texas two-step. They're creating another illusion by making the punching sounds with their feet. And you thought the Lord of the Dance made a lot of noise. Here's basic move number four, the kick.
It's all about minimizing the impact, you know. It's no different than a boxer rolling with a punch. The best way for a boxer to protect himself when a guy's hitting him with a punch is to roll with it.
The combination of ballet and brutality. The head kick takes perfect timing. In this case, some acting lessons wouldn't hurt either. Here's the secret. There's no real strength behind the kick because there is no kick. The All-American boy simply holds his foot up and brute force runs into it. The foot does make contact, but not where you think. Brute Force's hand, not head, takes the force of the blow, while his arm secretly guides the foot to its target. When he snaps his head back at just the right moment, the kick looks real, but we know it isn't. Finally, basic move number five, the headbutt.
Headbutts are awesome if you know how to do them. I'll hit my thumb or my hand. Sometimes I might not even come close.
The headbutt appears to be a savage and unmerciful act in which heads collide with raw energy. Of course, that would cause an instant concussion if the wrestlers really smashed heads, but they don't. The secret? With his hand on the All-American boy's head, Brute Force drives his forehead into his own thumb, pulling sharply away just as he connects. The audience goes right along for the ride. Now that you know the secrets behind these five basic moves, you'll never look at wrestling the same way again. So what makes these moves look so believable when you watch a match? Wrestlers call it the sell.
If I'm laying somebody beaten, and if they don't know how to sell what I'm doing to them, it's not going to look real. It's not going to look good.
These hits and kicks would look as phony as they really are if the victim didn't follow through with a good sell job. It's one of the secret ingredients that makes wrestling look so real.
When you receive a punch, you have to sell that punch. Your job is to sell, to grimace, to make the hold look painful, even though there's absolutely no pressure being applied to you whatsoever.
You can lose every match in the world. If you know how to sell, you could become a superhero because people will love you.
The wrestlers didn't grunt and groan or kick and scream in pain. This would look downright hokey. By selling the agony to the crowd, the fake fight looks vicious. But we know that the wrestlers aren't really hurting each other. Looks like the All-American boy is acting more like the All-American baby. This poke in the eye is pretty convincing. But let's take a closer look at what's really going on. Here, the thumb never comes close to the eye. But the fans buy it because of the sell. Here's the classic rake across the ropes. From the front, it looks like sheer torture. But from this angle, you can see that the wrestler's eye isn't even touching the rope. His fingers are protecting his face. All that screaming makes it believable. He continues the sell throughout this hold, which is called the arm bar. That's gotta hurt. Well, not really. Here's how it looks without the theatrics. Now see how convincing it looks when he sells it. That's showbiz.
Selling is vital because you want to make it look real. You sell the crowd on what you're doing. You make them believe while they're there. You know, it's no different than a stuntman in a movie or an actor, you know, acting like they're sad or happy or angry. While the people are there watching the match, they want to believe.
And they do believe, thanks to sell jobs like these. Coming up, you'll meet the mystery man who decides who wins and who loses every wrestling match.
Your main job is putting two people together that'll draw money.
Plus, the biggest secrets aren't on top of the ring, they're underneath it. Will you see what's hiding down there? And how do wrestlers fly out of the ring, bash into their opponents, and not get hurt? Find out how it's done when we expose more of wrestling's greatest secrets. But first, here's one of pro wrestling's fabulous fakes, the suplex. Skullduggery flips Slither upright. Shoulder to shoulder, he takes him down for a spine-crunching fall. Looks painful, but it's really not.
The secret of that is I'm cradling his neck in the crook of my elbow, and that way he does not make contact so his neck is not injured.
Here you can see Slither's neck being supported by Skullduggery's elbow. When the wrestlers drop to the ground, Slither secretly uses his opponent's arm to cushion his fall. All it takes is a little teamwork and a lot of salesmanship. We'll be back with more of wrestling's greatest secrets on NBC. By now, it's no secret that the action in the ring is less than real. What you don't know is that behind all this mayhem, there's a puppet master. Decides who wins and who loses. Who's going to be the hero? Who's going to be the villain? The man who orchestrates this big scam is called the Booker.
As a booker, your main job is putting two people together that'll draw money. Bookers are the boss.
The guy behind the scenes that gives the wrestlers their gimmicks.
And I will do what he says to the T. Because the man is paying me.
Backstage, before the match, the Booker concocts a secret plan. One wrestler is cast as the hero, or baby, while the other plays the role of the villain, better known as the heel.
So babyface is a superhero. He's a good guy, he don't cheat.
The baby is clean cut, he goes by the rules, he represents everything that's good. The heel is just the opposite.
Which is me.
They're the thugs, you know, the bad guys.
As the crowd enters the arena, the Booker is in the lobby, passing out specially made signs. On TV, this creates the illusion that the fans are really pumped up for the match. You didn't think they really brought all those signs from home, did you?
Calling a match involves getting into the ring with the person and talking to them and calling the spots or what wrestling holds or moves you're going to do next.
In the ring, the wrestlers do the Booker's bidding. He tells the good guy to lose, he loses. But how he does it is up to him and his partner.
Check him, ref! You better check him! Check him, ref! Check him! He's mine! He's mine! No!
The misconception is that the entire match is scripted, with every move perfectly choreographed. But how could two lugs remember all those intricate moves? They don't have to, because they're secretly talking to each other throughout the entire match.
The most common way to talk to the person, for example, is to take them down. My opponent would be on his butt, I'd have him in back chin lock, and I would be talking to him from there.
And he'd be telling him exactly what's coming next. With all the noise in the arena, the fans can't hear their secret conversation. They have no idea what's going on. Why don't we turn on the wrestler's hidden body mics and listen in?
I got him now, baby. Two elbows. I got him, baby. You're mine. You're mine. Tackle. You're mine. You're going out. Check him, ref. You better check him. Tuck the elbow. Check him, ref. Such a flip. Check him. He's mine. He's mine.
It all goes according to plan because the wrestlers are telling each other what to do. First, the two elbows. There's one and the second. Now the tackle. Right on cue. Then he ducks the elbow and follows up with the ever-popular sunset flip. Did you hear brute force call for a clothesline? The All-American boy sure did, and he was ready for it. But the audience couldn't hear the covert conversation, and that's what completes this illusion. There's another deception that fans can't see, even though they're staring at it during the entire match. It's not the wrestlers, it's the ring.
Oh!
It looks like the wrestlers are bashing their heads into solid steel turnbuckles with solid floor, but it's all just an illusion.
Turnbuckle covers are called corner pillows, and they don't hurt that much.
Why? 4 inches of foam rubber padding. Softer than an orthopedic pillow. But the secrets of the ring don't end there.
A wrestling ring is different from a boxing ring. A boxing ring has a very hard mat. A wrestling ring needs, in most cases, a little bit of give. Because it looks so much better if a wrestler takes another wrestler up and body slams them, and they hit the mat so hard they kind of bounce up.
But how is it possible? A peek under the canvas reveals the secret. Several layers of thick padding, the same kind used to break the falls of Hollywood stuntmen.
If you ever used a bedroll when you went camping, that's about the thickness of the pad.
But wait, there's more.
Some rings have a spring in the middle that absorbs some of the shock, but not all of it.
Hidden beneath the ring is a giant spring that cushions the wrestler's falls and gives them some real bounce. How's that for a shock absorber? And between the foam and the spring lies another secret. Loose sheets of plywood that provide an added bounce. An even more devious effect of the plywood is the bone-crushing sound it makes when a 250-pound body slams into the canvas. But lurking below is a bigger, more deceptive secret. A microphone sends those crashes and bangs through the arena's speaker system, amplifying them 100 times over.
So microphones put underneath the ring for the enhanced sound. Make a body slam or a backdrop or anything sound a lot worse than it actually is.
You'd think the fans would notice that the slams are louder near the speakers. Here's the way those punishing hits sound to the crowd. Ooh, better call a chiropractor. Now let's turn the hidden microphone off. Not nearly as impressive, is it? Next up, looks like the villain has just taken out one of the fans. But don't worry, it's all just part of the act. Then later, we'll reveal the secrets behind the backbreaker, the leg drop, the pile driver. Plus, is all that blood real or fake? We'll expose the shocking secrets. But first, another of wrestling's fabulous fakes, the splash. In this gag, Colossus works over Private Payne and softens him up for the kill. Then he bounces off the ropes and down he comes with the splash. So how come Private Payne doesn't experience a pain in his privates? No need to call 911. Hear the secrets. Colossus sends a warning to Private Payne so he can get into a safe position. There's the signal. That kick to the arm means tuck it in so it doesn't get broken. And now, the splash. Watch how Private Payne lifts his head up off the mat to absorb the shock. This also gives the illusion that he's had the life squashed out of him. The Colossus simply lands on his arms and knees. Wrestling fans have been tricked again.
You're
watching Exposed, pro wrestling's greatest secrets on NBC.
Go ahead.
Of course the ref is in on it. He knows exactly what goes on in that ring and when it will take place and when it will happen.
The referee begins every match with a search for foreign objects. As if those get-ups weren't foreign enough. Of course, the ref never finds anything. Why should he? He's in on the scam.
Guys, get back to your corners.
The real purpose of the shakedown is to give the ref time to pass on last-minute instructions from the booker to his wrestlers. But don't take our word for it. Let's turn on our secret microphone and hear it from the ref himself.
We're gonna need a couple extra minutes in the main event, okay? So we need you to jumpstart the crowd a little bit, jump the guy at the bell. We need a couple extra minutes for the main event here. He's gonna jump you at the bell, okay?
Guys, go back to your corners.
Referee is every bit as important as the two wrestlers are. But the more you're aware of him, the more he's doing his job.
When wrestlers can't communicate directly with each other, the ref acts as the messenger. This is known as passing a move. Listen as the ref relays the secret information.
Hey, come on. Let your man out of the corner. Open that. Let the man out of the corner. Come on. Let the man out of the corner.
Move.
How you doing, buddy? Move.
The ref slips out of the way at the last minute, and no one is the wiser.
The role of the referee, he is supposed to be about 5 seconds behind everybody else in the building. And that is everybody from the popcorn vendor to the guy taking tickets can see what's going on. But the referee just somehow misses it every time.
Instead of being a policeman in the ring, the ref is just one more con man.
Back in the corner.
One of his cheats is called the blind eye, where he conveniently overlooks an illegal move in order to stir up the fans.
I told the referee to call everything that he sees. Just don't put yourself in a position to see everything.
In this tag team match, the ref purposely turns away just as the tag is being made between the good guys. The ref appears to be reprimanding the villain for climbing into the ring, but he's really just waiting for the signal to turn back around. There's the signal. When the ref sees both good guys in the ring, he tries to kick one of them out. This leaves the villains free to beat the daylights out of his partner. They're all in on it together.
Now, everyone in the joint has seen this, but of course the referee hasn't seen it. And as the traditional rule goes in wrestling, if the referee does not see it, then it did not happen.
Why do they pull this con? To get the crowd all worked up. When fans see the good guy being pummeled behind the ref's back, they become enraged.
The crowd then, because they've seen this, they get mad at the referee. They're mad at the heel wrestler because this great injustice has happened. And there's nothing they can do about it, just like real life.
The ref also serves another underhanded purpose. He paces the action in the ring, making sure the fans' blood pressure rises to a boiling point at just the right moment. Of course, there's a trick to how he does it. The ref is secretly given directions by the ringside announcer, who is constantly monitoring the excitement level of the fans. If the crowd is hot, a discreet two-finger signal tells the ref to let the action continue for 10 more minutes. But if the crowd is losing interest, he puts up one finger, telling the ref to wrap it up in 5. And when he sees the announcer's pen, the ref knows it's time to bring down the curtain.
Bring it home, boy.
Within seconds, the match is over. And the third man in the ring has successfully carried out his secret mission.
Heat is basically anything that gets the crowd to erupt. You know, a heel, when he's getting heat, obviously it's boos and hisses. When the babyface is getting heat, it's cheers and applause.
I'm there to entertain fans, and I entertain the fans by making them hate me and love the baby.
One of the best ways for a wrestler to make sure the fans will cheer the hero and boo the villain is to use the microphone to provoke the crowd. They call this cheap heat because it's an easy way to get the fans riled up.
To be honest, to have thousands of people booing and cheering and hissing you is a lot of fun because you've done your job well.
Another surefire trick to generate heat is by brawling, climbing out of the ring and taking the action up close and personal.
A lot of wrestlers brawl. That's their way of exciting the crowd. And it does get them on their feet. A lot of people like to see brawling. It's violent.
Wrestlers slap each other's bodies with their forearms to make the fight sound real. Now they've got the crowd in the palms of their sweaty hands. But there are other ways to stir up the fans, like enlisting the help of the wrestler's girlfriend.
Come on, get him!
If she sees me in trouble, I mean, she'll grab the guy's foot. I then kick him in the back, throw him out of the ring.
Step back. Oh!
Then I will grab the referee. And I'll say, yo, what is your problem? Why don't you leave me alone? In the meantime, I'm chit-chatting. My girl is laying that man a beating outside, which is helping me.
Step back.
And once I notice she's done doing her job, I'll tell me to turn around.
Turn around.
See her standing there in the corner, not doing anything.
And wrestling is not what it appears to be. In that sense, we're exactly like Hollywood or the movies, because everything you see is a total illusion.
From the moment the wrestlers enter the arena, their plan is to work the crowd. The villain's job is to act as despicable as he can. He wants the crowd to really hate him. There's no better way to turn up the heat than the old autograph bit. It's a piece of business that makes the fans despise the villain for tearing up a little kid's autograph book. Sure enough, this crowd is outraged.
The autograph book routine is one of the oldest routines in wrestling.
And guess what? This kid is secretly part of the con. He's a shill who's been planted there by the booker. When the heel grabs the autograph book and tears it in half, the kid does his best to act stunned and upset. But it's really just part of the hustle.
You're working them. You're taking their emotions on a roller coaster ride. You can make them happy. You can make them sad. You can make them angry. And what you're doing is you're working them.
The heel gets booed just as planned. And what about the boy? He gets pizza and a ride home. Because here's the other secret. He's usually one of the wrestler's own kids.
Everything is under our total control from the minute we walk in the ring until the minute we leave the ring.
There's another character planted in the audience that you'd never expect to be on the payroll. And when she plays her big scene, she creates more heat than you could ever imagine. Can you pick out the plant? It couldn't be this sweet old lady. How's that for pile driving, Miss Daisy?
My best way to generate heat from the audience is just my arrogance walking down to the ring. I think there's a little part of acting to it.
Now here's the secret. She's a stunt granny. And every night she puts on her pads and takes a fall. The two guys behind her are also plants who keep her from getting hurt. But does Granny really hate the wrestlers? Hardly. Later backstage, they take a moment to show their gratitude for a con job well done. Still to come, one of these props is not a fake. Can you spot the one that's real? Is it the trophy to the skull? The salt in the eyes? Or is it the folding chair across the back? Plus, it looks like this wrestler is getting pile-drived into the mats, but he doesn't feel a thing. How do they do it? First, another of wrestling's fabulous fakes, the backdrop. Watch as Colossus lifts Slither high into the air and slams him into the mat. But you don't see Slither struggling to get free, do you? That's because there's a secret to how it's done. Actually, the higher up he is, the more time Slither has to prepare for a safe landing. How he lands is critical and determines whether he rides home in a stretch limo, stretched out in an ambulance. To achieve maximum height, Slither pushes off Colossus's shoulders and vaults himself into the air. He then extends his arms, creating as much surface area as possible to cushion the fall. The impact is absorbed by his feet and shoulders, and not by his spine. Stay tuned for more secrets on NBC.
Exclusive offer from NBC Home Video. Are they masters of mayhem or fabulous fakes? Call 1-800-NBC-4144 right now for your copy of Exposed, Pro Wrestling's Greatest Secrets. For just $19.95 plus shipping and handling, you can find out what the wrestling federations don't want you to know. Find out what's real and what's not.
Step in a ring and we'll show you how fake it is.
Call now, 1-800-NBC-4144.
Bet if you see someone with a trophy or a chair, you just know there's going to be some trouble.
No Hollywood movie set would be complete without its elaborate props. And no wrestling ring would be complete without them either.
That's it!
What are you doing?
Hey, freak!
When a wrestler's pretty girlfriend brings a trophy into the ring, you just know it's going to be smashed over someone's head. But taking a solid metal trophy to the skull night after night is a risk even these macho men aren't willing to take. Here's the secret. A prop trophy that's cut in half, then glued back together, is guaranteed to break on cue. Each and every time. One of the oldest tricks in the book is the salt in the eyes routine, where a wrestler throws a handful of salt into the face of his opponent. Aside from the danger posed by throwing real salt into someone's eyes, it's hard to see. So what's the secret?
Salt is not actually salt. It would usually be weightlifter's chalk or talcum powder or baby powder because it makes a cloud that you can see even up in the balcony.
But there are still more props in the wrestler's bag of tricks.
Those chairs aren't fake. I mean, you get hit with it, you get hit.
So how does a wrestler take a solid steel chair to the head and live to tell about it? There's a secret to that, too.
The chair is absolutely positively real. When someone takes a chair shot, the chair bends.
It makes a lot of noise, but it really doesn't do that much damage. If you hit the person across the broad of the back and he instinctively grabs the back of his head, the illusion of the crowd will be you just whacked him up the back of the head with a chair.
Notice how wrestlers always take time to fold the chair. It's not because neatness counts. It's part of the secret. First, he makes the chair as flat as possible. Then, he smashes the back of the chair into the beefiest part of his opponent's shoulder, where it won't hurt him. The victim quickly grabs his head in pain, and the audience assumes he's been whacked in the skull. But we know better. Now that you know the secrets of the folding chairs, let's check out the tables. They gotta be fake, right? Wrong. The tables are real, too.
It hurts. There's nothing fake about going through a table. I mean, nothing whatsoever.
As Colossus and Brute Force battle it out ringside, they're really just setting up another scam. Let's see what they've got in mind. Just when it looks like Brute Force has gotten the upper hand, Colossus spins his opponent around and sends him flying. But if the table is real, how do they avoid injury? Here's the secret. The underside of the table hasn't been sawed through like you might expect. It's made of lightweight particle board, which is nothing more than pressed sawdust.
A regular standard 8-foot table made out of particle board is broken with about, 200-300 pounds pressure coming down on top of it.
We like to put them through right dead center. Put them right dead center, this way you know it's gonna break.
The idea is to hit the table in the middle, at its weakest point. It's simple physics. Since the table is softer than the concrete floor, it breaks the wrestler's fall. But it sure looks dangerous to the fans, because they don't know the secrets. When we return, our wrestlers confess their darkest secrets, how they pull off their most devastating moves. The bulldog headlock, the leg drop, the backbreaker. It may look like they're killing each other, but looks can be deceiving. Plus, the truth behind wrestling's biggest and bloodiest secret. But first, another one of wrestling's fabulous fakes, the flying body block. When wrestlers fly out of the ring, the crowd goes wild. But this move could result in serious injury if there wasn't a secret. Here's how they do it. Skullduggery knows exactly when Slither will be winging his way toward him. So he's waiting with open arms to catch him and break his fall. Just another happy landing when you know the secret. We'll expose more of wrestling's greatest secrets here on NBC. At the end of a match, the blood is flowing. But is it real or just part of the act?
Juicing is causing yourself to bleed.
Hey, open the fist! Open the fist! Hey, open the fist! Come on, step back! What's wrong with
the granddaddy of all cons is when a wrestler is literally beaten to a bloody pulp.
Hey, out of your man's hair! Out of the man's hair! Hey, what are you doing? Hey, come here!
What?
What's wrong with you? What are you doing? What do you think you're doing?
Nothing.
Juicing is simply where the person cut himself in the ring and bleed just to add more realism to that match.
Wrestling fans think that the All-American Boy has bloodied his opponent's head, but he had nothing to do with it. From this angle, we can see that Brash Knuckles doesn't come anywhere close to the turnbuckle. So why all the blood? Well, most people think it's fake. Well, here's a secret you wouldn't expect. That's a real cut. And the blood's real, too. But how did it get there? Let's take a closer look. As the ref steps in to check on Brash Knuckles' condition, he secretly passes off a tiny sliver of a razor blade wrapped in tape.
Stay there.
How you doing, Matt? Here it is.
There's the handoff. If you didn't know where to look, you'd miss it. So much for the ref being impartial, but we already knew he was in on it. You may want to look away, because this part gets pretty gruesome.
Hey, what are you doing? Help!
With the concealed blade, he secretly makes a small incision in the crease of his brow. He knows exactly where to cut.
The wrong way is taking a long, broad stroke across the forehead. That results in long scars. You can get a tremendous injuries. The right way is you go to the bone and take just a little jerk. It will bleed profusely, and 2 to 3 days later, it'll be healed.
It's hard to believe how far pro wrestlers will go to make the carnage look real and keep the fans coming back for more.
A finishing move is a devastating move. It's a move where the fans in that crowd are like, damn, he ain't getting up.
The ultimate act of chicanery comes at the end of the match. It's called a finishing move, and it's guaranteed to bring the bout to a dramatic conclusion. One showstopper is called the backbreaker.
A backbreaker is one of the unusual finishing moves in wrestling. The whole trick to this being you're falling down on your knee and just barely placing him on the knee that's upright.
Watch as the two wrestlers hold each other tightly so their weight will be evenly distributed. Now here's the secret. Private Payne actually lands on his feet, not on his back, as he'd have you believe.
He feels no discomfort from this. It's a very easy move to take, and it's actually worse to the person giving the move than the person getting the move.
Worse, because Colossus has the job of supporting all their weight. Private Payne clutches tightly to his opponent so he can fully extend his legs. See how his feet take the impact. Although the illusion is a broken back, it's Colossus who's out of breath. Another spectacular finisher is the Hurricanrana. Slither tries to whip Skullduggery into the turnbuckle, but he ends up on the canvas. Skullduggery pretends to be dazed while Slither gets into position. Up and over, he buries him with the mighty Hurricanrana. And this match is over.
There are a lot of different variations of the Hurricanrana. There's no doubt about it. It's very risky.
It's risky, all right, unless you know the secret. Don't watch Slither, because he's not in charge here. It's Skullduggery who controls the move. Watch as he does a full forward flip, driving himself into the canvas. He makes sure to get full rotation so he doesn't squash his opponent. Meanwhile, Slither tucks his head in to avoid hitting the ring post. That's how it's done. Another finishing move is the leg drop. It's an elaborate maneuver where a wrestler appears to knock the air out of his opponent by crushing his windpipe. But here's how it really works.
Your opponent's on his back, you jump up in the air, you basically land on your butt, your leg will land harmlessly on your opponent's chest.
Colossus's leg doesn't even touch Private Payne's neck, but the move happens so fast, the fans can't spot the secret. It's Private Payne's sell job that puts it over the top. Watch again. Colossus goes down, but his knee is bent, creating an arch, and leaving his opponent plenty of breathing room. Here's another big finisher. Looks like the hero is about to lose, but a smart booker wouldn't let that happen. So the good guy employs a tricky move to make his comeback. The bulldog headlock.
A bulldog headlock's where you have your opponent in a headlock, you jump up in the air, you land on your butt, and the idea behind that is it looks like you've driven your opponent's head into the mat.
The secret? The opponent's head never hits the canvas. Watch again. As they go down, Skullduggery breaks his fall with his forearms. By the time the All-American boy lands, he's released his opponent. He breaks his own fall, and Skullduggery lands on his beefy arms. But he sells the move by grabbing his head and howling in pain. And now the most dangerous finishing move in all of wrestling. The pile driver.
Pile driver is a devastating move. Even if you've taken the bump 1,000 times, it doesn't take but one time, one mistake. You could be paralyzed.
Here's how Private Payne avoids a broken neck. His head is tucked up between his opponent's thighs, so it doesn't really slam into the mat. Private Payne's shoulders take all the impact, not his head.
When I land, I'll land vicious and hard, but most of the shock will be to my butt and upper thigh area.
Private Payne uses his arms to push himself up at the moment of impact. The fans think he's been pile-drived into the canvas head first.
If you land the wrong way, you aren't going to get up from a pile driver. You'll probably just be stretchered out.
But you'll be safe as long as you know the secret. Don't go away. We'll be back with a final word from our wrestlers. Exposed, Pro Wrestling's Greatest Secrets, returns on NBC.
Do you ask more from a truck than 99?
For professional wrestlers, pulling off the secrets is one thing, but taking all that punishment is another. The fact is, these men endure a tremendous amount of physical abuse in the ring. Over the years, they've suffered more bumps and bruises than they care to count.
I've had a lot of injuries, and none of those injuries were fake. The times that I've been busted open, the scars that I have on my body, those are not fake. Those are all real.
No one's supposed to get hurt, but people do get hurt. So what you see in professional wrestling is real.
I've had 16 concussions in 1 year.
I've been hurt quite a few times, been in the hospital. quite a few times with stitches, broken ribs, fractured wrist. The list goes on. To be honest with you, I'm one of the lucky ones.
You can get killed in wrestling. There's been a number of wrestlers that have had their necks broken. And if it wasn't for their physical conditioning, they would have died.
It doesn't take but one time, one mistake, and your career could be over and possibly your life.
I would challenge anyone from the crowd to get in the ring and do what we do for one day.
Now that you know the secrets, you decide. How fake is it?
After watching this show, if you still got the guts to ask any pro wrestler, is it fake? Step into the ring and we'll show you how fake it is.